Morning, ladies, gents, and jerks. I don't normally get political on this channel, for good reason. I tend to avoid getting into politics because it just doesn't go well. No matter what you try, there's always somebody juxtaposed to you. But this has been bothering me for a while. Something I just need to get off my chest. So, you're gonna look at the title of the video, you're gonna make conclusions, and you're gonna hear the first bit of this, you're gonna jump to more conclusions. But stick around, I'll explain everything. I'll cite my things that I reference, if I put them either annotation link, or both annotation link and in the description below. If I'm referencing something in this off-the-cuff ramble, and I can't find what I'm trying to source, I'll put a little message saying error 404, reference not found, which is a problem that happens a lot, because I, at least in general conversation, I reference things that nobody my age really should know, like Hogan's Heroes, I Dream of Jeannie, Bewitched. People my age shouldn't really know that sort of stuff, but I do. So, yeah, it's an often found error. But back to the topic. Why do I support Donald Trump? Now. Why do I now support Donald Trump, I should say. Get your knees ready to jerk. Are they ready? Prepared? It's because I'm a white male. Ah. Have your knees finished jerking yet? Hey there, puppy dog. Now, why do I say this? A year ago, I was staunchly liberal. Come here, puppy. There's something cute. A year ago, I was staunchly liberal. 6 months ago, I was anti-Trump. But now, I'm 100% pro-Trump. Why? Because I am a white male. And the regressive left has done everything they can to drive me away. I was literally forced towards the right. And now I find myself, instead of being center-left like I used to be, I'm now more and more going center-right. It's an odd feeling that when you actually witness it happening, especially when you know why. For example, when you've got things like, in a I just read this a little while ago, a pharmacy is now charging men 7% tax because we have a dick. In the name of equality. Yahoo, purging male employees. In the name of equality. The BBC saying white men need not apply. Because equality. In New York, there's a private school that has instituted segregation. Black kids get cupcakes, white kids get guilt trips. Yeah. Segregation. Who'd have thought people my age would ever see that? I thought we were done with it by the 60s, when it was made illegal. But apparently not. Apparently, everyone seems to have forgotten Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream. A dream where his kids would grow up in a world where people are not judged by the color of their skin, but the color of their character. Which is a lost notion anymore. Because in the name of equality, they've made it unequal. In the name of equality, I'm getting fucked over. No whites need apply. Well, fuck you too. So because of that, and because of where it's coming from, I've been pushed further and further because of the race baiting on the left. You can't go a week, barely a day, without some sort of race baiting. Generally in the form of, this black guy got hurt or killed by the cops. And I used to watch the Young Turks all the time. But I'm now anti them because all they seem to be doing was race bait. And that's when I saw them doing that, realized what they were doing, and got away from them. And that's when I started drifting more and more to the right. Probably be on screen to your left, but it's my right. So, that's when it started. Because I saw what they were doing. Race bait. They're making, and especially with the feminists doing the same thing. All they're doing, with they're throwing the labels out like that, they're driving people apart. And by doing so, they're demonizing me. They literally said, which might be harder to find the specific examples, maybe not actually, but they've literally said, all white men are racist, all white men are sexist, and that you can't be racist or sexist towards white men because privilege, whatever the fuck that's supposed to mean. And apparently, I wish I was bullshitting about this, a homeless white man is more privileged than a millionaire black guy. Because he has less melanin in his skin, so he's more privileged because he gets sunburns easier? The fuck? Genuinely, what the fuck? What the fuck, dog? He's looking at me all sorts of confused. He's a good boy. He's my good boy. So, yeah. Because of bullshit like that, I've been pushed. Rightward. So, that's really the only outcome. Two outcomes. It's the only outcome. There's two of them. Yeah. Two things could have happened. It was just like when it came to religion. I could either follow along or not. I could have bowed to the narrative or stood with the evidence. I stood. Again, I stood. I remain honest. And I always will be. That's the chair. Not my butt. It's the chair. If it was the dog, I'd be passing out. But the narrative has become far more important than the facts. Stupid buddy. Like, again, we're going back to the race baiting. Do you know why more black people are having problems with cops? Because more black people are committing crime. Source, about 70% of murders are committed by black people. More than 50% are robberies. And on average, 30% or more of the crimes. How is this a mystery? You get more police attention when you commit more crime. What we should be asking is, not now, puppy. Why are they committing more crime? A number of reasons, not going to go into it. Though, the whole fuck the police thing doesn't help. But, chill. So, that I can cover later if you really need, though I think Sargon of Akkad might have covered it a lot better than I ever will be able to. Plus, his voice is a whole lot better than mine. But my puppy dog's cuter. Yeah, good boy. So, because of that, I've been pushed to the right. Because of the regressives pushing this bullshit that I'm the devil because of my reproductive bits and the melanin in my skin, I've had nowhere to go. That's the only place I can go, is more to the right. So, this isn't even counting Shillery's bullshit corruption that's so painfully fucking obvious that it's just astounding. I mean, earlier today and quite a few other times, I've tried to get one of the very rare Shillery supporters. Yes, I say Shillery. I type Shillery because it's basically her name now. It's just a reflex. She's my good boy. But I've been trying to get one of them to address the point, because they're making a huge fuss about Trump talking bullshit over a decade ago with another guy. Something, well, I don't generally do. I try to keep that kind of bullshit on the down low, but pretty much everyone else has, man and woman. Well, I've probably done it a few times. Everyone talks bullshit like that. And they're throwing a big fuss about that because the media's telling them to. And yet, no one wants to address that Hillary's covered up hacks Hillary's covered up and harassed, all the shit that her husband's done, you know, genuine sexual assault, and nobody seems to want to bring up the fact that she got a guy named Thomas, I forget his last name, who she knew was guilty of raping a 12-year-old. She got him off the hook knowing that he did it. And nobody wants to address that. Nobody wants to bring up that fact. They're fine digging up shit from a decade ago on Trump, but something far worse for Hillary? No, no. No touchy. No touchy. So, yeah. Back when Bernie was a candidate, I supported him. But he's sold out. Sleeping with the devil. So, in this election, I've got no choice. It's either bed with the ones that make me a demon, or go with the populist crazy guy. Yes, puppy, you're cute. So, yeah. Anyways, yeah. I've got no other option. I've been demonized, and this is what I can do. All I can do is say, fuck them. I'm not giving up my free speech. Tally, stinking home.